Hi, and welcome to a new 3D Equalizer 4 tutorial. In this video, we introduce one of our new features shipping with release 7.1, named Align 3D Model to 3D Model. This video contains two parts. The first one shows how to align basic 3D models. The second one shows how to work with detailed 3D scans, LiDAR scans, and similar models. So what is this feature about? Let's take a look at our example models to give a quick overview about what to expect. To demonstrate, our process here is to align a variety of different models onto the leftmost red model. When working with 3D models and scenes, it sometimes happens that a model needs to be replaced by a different model after the work has already been done. This can end up in quite the hassle for the artist, and the process is very prone to errors. With our new feature, we hope to simplify this process and achieve better results. The first model we are going to align to the red one contains exactly the same geometry data. However, its pivot point is vastly different. To align the blue model to the red one, select both of them and go up to the 3D Models menu. Here you choose Align 3D Model to 3D Model. A new window will pop up and give you several options. Let's take a look at them. Align. Here you can check which model is going to be the target model. Allow Scaling. Allows to scale the to-be-aligned model uniformly. Allow Rotation. Enables rotation of the aligned new model. Allow Translation. Allows translation of the newly aligned 3D model. Enhanced Calculation. Should always be checked for more proper calculation, but might take a bit longer to compute. Pre-alignment. Here you'll have the option to select automatic or manual pre-alignment of the to-be-modified model. We'll explain this in detail later. Reference points is for deciding how many reference points should be used for calculation. Since at this point we want to align the blue model onto the red one, we select blue onto red instead of red onto blue. After calculating, a pop-up will tell us how close the reference points are to the target model. This number is very good. The goal should always be to get these numbers as low as possible. And when we now deselect our models, we can see that the red and blue colors have mixed into purple. If we zoom in, we can see how smoothly aligned everything is, and we can now disable the blue model. Our next example model contains different geometry data. The green model we now want to align is quite low poly, and therefore has a rougher geometry compared to the red one. Once again, we select both models and then open the Align 3D Model to 3D Model requester. We check if the chosen models are selected correctly and try the standard settings again. Since one of the models is low poly, we can expect a higher deviation in this case, so let's take a look at it. The alignment looks pretty good. If we zoom in, we can see all vertices aligned properly. The shape of all parts are fitting, the camera position, the curve of the helmet, and even the tube. So let's continue. The next demo model basically shares the same geometry data as the red one. However, as you can see, a large part is simply missing. As a consequence, the two models already differ fundamentally. Again, select the two models and open up the Align 3D Model to 3D Model requester. Check if everything is set up correctly and start the calculation. The numbers look pretty fine. Let's take a closer look. The vertices are aligned pretty perfectly. We can see at the seam lines that they are well adjusted. On to the next part. For this part, we want to add a new piece onto our already known red model. In this case, a new helmet. In comparison to the previous example, both models differ even more now. They actually only share a fraction of geometry data. Let's see how this turns out. We once again select our desired models and go to the Align 3D Model requester. If we use the standard settings, we can already see that the result won't be good. The numbers are off and way too high. The helmet has moved to the center of the suit, which is obviously totally wrong. To work around this, we translate the helmet up and rotate it roughly into the position where it should be. No need to waste time on being exact here though. After selecting our models again, we once more open up the Align 3D Model menu. This time though we choose Pre-Alignment User Defined. This option prevents 3DE from moving the to-be-aligned model onto the center of mass of the target model. Instead, you have the freedom to pre-align the model roughly into place before 3DE's optimization process kicks in. Our result is way better now, but still far from perfect. No reason to worry though. You can repeatedly execute this function since pre-alignment is set to user-defined. Each time it is called, the result gets improved until a minimal deviation has been reached. As you can see, the helmet is way better aligned to the original model now, but there's still a noticeable deviation. Let's run the procedure one more time. Well, will you look at that? Everything is in its correct position, and we can see that all faces are properly aligned. Our last example for these models will be a tricky one. Here we have a low pulley model on which a high-res partial model needs to be aligned onto. Just like the last time, we first roughly reposition the helmet. Translate it, rotate it until pleased, select both models, and then open our trusty Align 3D Model Requester. Once again, we choose User-Defined Pre-Alignment and let it do its thing. Not happy. Let's try again. Now, we could try this over and over until we're satisfied, but there's an easy way to speed this up. This time, instead of using just 16 reference points, we are going to use 128 points. Now look at that result. For a base model this difficult to work with, this looks pretty neat. Remember, because we have selected user-defined pre-alignment mode, this new function can be applied several times in a row in order to improve the result step by step. We hope this new feature will be of good use for you and allow for an easier workflow. Now let's see how this feature handles a detailed LiDAR scan of a scenery. This beautiful scan we can see here has been made by Helder Tomasz from Veritas VFX. Veritas VFX supplies productions with VFX-ready on-set data using battle-tested techniques that are guaranteed to save time and money on the back end. The two scans we want to combine have some small differences between them. Position and rotation are different, as well as the vertex count on both of them. The orange model on the left is slightly higher detailed than the blue one on the right. The challenge here is that both models are very detailed, with an overall high vertex count. In addition to that, they only slightly overlap at one side. In comparison, in our previous examples, one of the models has always been entirely contained in the other. As we learned before, we already know that we first have to bring these parts roughly into position. We can try to use 16 reference points, but the result is often pretty bad with such high vertex numbers. So let's repeat the step with 128 reference points instead. The numbers are good already. Let's check the models now as well. We can see at the window sills and hooks that this result is very good. If we, for example, compare the complex shingles of the roof, it looks pretty perfect, so we can rest this case now. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial and will make good use of our new feature. Make sure to check out our other tutorials showing the new features coming with 3DEqualizer4 release 7.1.